So central banks are also starting to understand nature has real value. Carbon, we already figured out. And carbon is moving very quickly into a system where it's going to be very close to a currency. Basically being able to take a ton of absorbed or sequestered carbon and being able to create a forward pricing curve with financial service architecture, documentation. I just came out of a meeting this morning how we're trying to accelerate that. To be quite honest, not to get very boring, but we're on financial topics and things, but they're going to be derivatives. And you need ISDA documentation if you want to trade a derivative in the marketplace. And all of this actually matters for nature as well. I'm going to quickly hand off, but again, I want to talk about value one more time, because the southern part of the world has value far greater than large elements of the northern part. And when we start thinking about and putting prices on water, on trees, on biodiversity, we find, where does that sit? I'm doing a lot of work out of Asia, and I say that my next door neighbor, Indonesia, is the left lung of the world, and obviously Brazil's the right, and Africa, absolutely critical. And we need their natural capital as a system-based world more than we need that $66 billion we've got sitting in the basement of the Bank of England. So how do we, and I'm hoping this discussion today, at least from a central banker's point of view, on how do we start tokenizing, how do we start building systems that actually create not only the value, but transfer that value around the world?
the first day it was very cold, it was raining, and I was alone the first day, but already the second day, after a couple of hours, people started joining, and yeah, then after that I'm almost never alone when I sit there.
och du är också ledare av organisationen och är dessutom ordförande i Global Utmaning. Varmt välkomna. Nu har vi en panel som har bestämt sig för att göra någonting. Alltså, som är varse hela delar eller...
världen. Jag tänkte lämna över mikrofonen till dig och det är faktiskt så att hela världen lyssnar och det är ganska häftigt. Varsågod.
Tack. Some people say that we are not doing enough to fight climate change, but that is not true, because to not do enough, you have to do something. And the truth is, we are basically not doing anything. Yes, some people are doing more than they can, but they are too few and too far from power to make a difference today. Some people say that the climate crisis is something that we all have created, but that is just another convenient lie. Because if everyone is guilty, then no one is to blame. And someone is to blame. Some people, some companies, and some decision makers in particular has known exactly what priceless values they are sacrificing to continue making unimaginable amounts of money. I want to challenge those companies and those decision makers into real and bold climate action, to set their economic goals aside and to safeguard the future living conditions for humankind. I don't believe for one second that you will rise to that challenge, but I want to ask you all the same. I ask you to prove me wrong, for the sake of your children, for the sake of your grandchildren, for the sake of life and this beautiful living planet. I ask you to stand on the right side of history. I ask you to pledge to do everything in your power to push your own business or government in line with the 1.5 degree world. Will you pledge to do that? Will you pledge to join me and the people all around the world in doing whatever it takes?
Some people, some companies, some decision makers in particular have known exactly what priceless values they have been sacrificing to continue making unimaginable amounts of money. And I think many of you here today belong to that group of people. I want to say first that the future of humankind rests firmly in your hands.
We kids don't usually do what you tell us to do. We do what you do. And because you don't give a damn about my future, I won't either. My name is Greta and I school strike until the Swedish election day.
do you want to tell world leaders here in Davos?
I want to tell them very much, but just simply that if we do not care about the climate crisis and the environment, then no other issue is going to matter in the future, because this is what shapes the future. And yeah,
thank you. Urgent.
My message at the COP24 meeting in Katowice was that we didn't come there to beg world leaders to care about our future, because they have ignored us in the past and they will ignore us again unless something happens. And so we have come there to let them know that change is coming, whether they like it or not. And I think I have the same message now, but as you said, more urgent, because they didn't achieve very much at the COP, so it's more urgent now.
I agree.